In this tutorial, we're going to look at two methods that you can use to create black and white images in Photoshop. We're going to work with this image of Venice. We have the layer here. And the first way of creating black and white images is, of course, to use the black and white adjustment layer. It's non-destructive, and you have the ability to control the original colors and how bright or how dark they appear in the black and white image. So, for example, if I click and drag on this reds slider, the pixels that were originally red become darker. If I click and drag the yellow slider to the right, the pixels that were originally yellow become brighter. And I can make the sky darker, of course, by clicking and dragging on the blue slider. You'll notice that the black and white adjustment layer has six sliders: reds, yellows, greens, cyans, blues, and magentas. And this is a great way of making black and white images. I recommend using this technique. But in this video, we're going to focus on a different technique. And if you've been watching the Photoshop training channel for a while, you'll know that I like control. So I'm going to show you another method that gives you slightly more control as to how you're going to create your black and white images. So I'm going to click and drag this black and white adjustment layer to the trash icon to delete it. Then I'm going to show you how to create a black and white image using the camera raw filter. You always want to work non-destructively, so I'm going to right-click to the side of the layer and click on Convert to Smart Object. Then I'm going to go into Filter, Camera Raw Filter. In the Camera Raw Filter, I'm going to click on the HSL/Grayscale tab, then click on Convert to Grayscale. And this is going to give us a black and white image, and you're going to see 8 sliders that are very similar to the black and white adjustment layer. I can click and drag on the red slider to make the original pixels darker or brighter. The biggest difference, though, is that with Camera Raw, we get 2 extra sliders. We get the orange slider and we get the purple slider. We don't have a cyan slider, but we have an aqua slider. Overall, we have 2 more sliders, so slightly more control. Also, when working in Camera Raw, if you have this icon checked, the shadow clipping warnings and the highlight clipping warnings, you will see warnings on screen when we start clipping pixels, meaning when we lose detail. So if I click and drag that red slider all the way to the left, you'll see that these areas become blue. That is Photoshop telling us that those pixels lost all detail and they're pure black. And that's something that you may want to keep your eye on, and this becomes very helpful for that. So I'm going to click and drag on the red slider and bring it to right about this area here. Also adjust the oranges to continue making those areas darker. I'm going to make the yellows a little bit brighter. And I'm also going to make the sky darker by clicking and dragging the blue slider to the left. I'm not worried about the water. We're going to work on that separately in a moment. Another thing that you may want to do while in the Camera Raw filter is add a little bit of sharpening. As you might have seen in a recent video about sharpening, you always want to sharpen at 100% so that you can really see what's going on. Then click on the Detail tab, and you can click and drag the amount to sharpen the image. And you can also reduce a little bit of the noise that we bring in by clicking and dragging on the luminance slider under noise. If I click on this icon here, you'll see the before and the after. In this case, I think the sharpening works, so I'm going to press OK. Now we're going to work with the water separately. So I'm going to press Ctrl J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate the layer. Then I'm going to click on the rectangular marquee tool and make a selection right around the bottom part of the image containing the water. Then I'm going to click on the new layer mask icon to create a layer mask. This layer mask will make only the water visible in that layer. So now we can work with the water independently from the rest of the image. So I can click on the down pointing arrow and then click on the Camera Raw Filter label to bring up the Camera Raw Filter once again and make adjustments to the water. I'm going to click on the HSL tab and then click on Default so that we can start from scratch. Now, when I start making adjustments to the image, don't worry about the buildings or the sky. All we really care about is the water. So I'm going to make a few adjustments to try to make the water look a bit more dramatic. And by the way, you can see the blue that is clipping the buildings. Don't worry about that. They're not going to be visible on the final image. Also, while on this filter, we can go into the Curves tab and click on Point, and then click and drag to make an S-curve, like so, to add more contrast to the image, and then press OK. So now this top layer only controls the water. I can rename it by double clicking on it and typing water. So that's before and after. And if you want to adjust the water, I can always double click on the label and adjust it accordingly. And this is just another method that I recommend you use when making black and white images. And there's nothing wrong with using the black and white adjustment layer to create black and white images in Photoshop. The point of this tutorial was to simply show you another method that gives you slightly more control and that can become very useful in certain cases. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.